Good morning, traders from United World Capital and Cyprus. Today, it's a very bright morning in global markets, and again, Mr. Ben Bernanke and the Federal Reserve have done wonders to the global markets. Stock markets were rallying after the decision of the Federal Reserve yesterday to then release now on a monthly basis $50 billion to continue to buy bonds or monetary quantitative easing as the markets have been hoping for now during the whole summer. The initiative made wonders with the markets. The US market was skyrocketing yesterday. This trend has continued in Asia this morning, where the South Asian Pacific Index is up more than 2.5%, along with the Shanghai Composite. Also, commodity prices are skyrocketing. Copper prices are at the highest levels for months, and we see the same trend with then gold, which reaches $1,776, up $50 during only some few hours. Silver is skyrocketing on $3,480. And of course, this initiative from the Federal Reserve had a very strong impact as well on the currencies. As I said and mentioned yesterday, I expected to see the 130 level in relation between euro and US dollar during the end of the week. This happened already this morning when the euro brushed through the 130 level, and it's now trading on 130.24 against the US dollar. The US dollar is basically weaker in relation to all currencies. And that is a byproduct of the Federal Reserve's decision. Many observers are talking about a direct currency manipulation in an effort where the Federal Reserve tries to write down the value of the dollar to make US products more competitive and thereby strengthening US exports in the international trading markets. That has, as a matter of fact, is now in the process of taking place. Another very important part of the package that came from Federal Reserve yesterday is, of course, that Ben Bernanke is very, very much concerned, and the Federal Reserve has for weeks been very concerned over the weak development in American jobs. Unemployment rates is still at a very high level, approximately 1.2%, when the last statistics was presented. And now we are hoping, and the Federal Reserve is hoping, that this should be an engine also for new growth in the US economy, and unemployment level could be reduced to 7.5% or more than 0.5%. For the stock markets all over the world, this is a very, 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 very important injection. And I presume that also gold and silver, precious metals, would skyrocket still due to in the inflationary pressure that these bond buying is going to create. I think that we would still see a high level in the euro-US dollar ratio, and also, of course, other currencies would be strengthened if they are oil or commodity related. It's interesting to see that oil prices are again reaching the high levels that we saw for a year ago, Brent crude is trading very close to 117 this morning, of course as a result of the monetary easing from the Federal Reserve, but also due to the fact that there is increased tension in the Middle East. Oil-producing Libya experienced a tragic event with the death of the American ambassador the other day, and no demonstrations against US is continuing all over the Middle East as a result of the blasphemy that the most of the Islam world is looking at this new American movie about Muhammad. They are taking as blasphemy, and that is of course creating an explosive situation. I think that we are in for a very interesting and challenging trading day, and I wish all of you a good trades, and I wish you also a very nice weekend from United World Capital and Cyprus. Thank you.